Our global issue is education for all. We believe education is not only about learning how to read or write, but more about learning how to express yourself, be creative, and love yourself. And we also believe that education is about becoming self-directed learners and able communicators that eventually accomplish your goals. Now, my fellow friend, Diallo, is going to talk about our project.
Okay, so why did we choose this project? So, we chose this project because in the Dominican Republic, there is a lot of physical and sexual abuse, violence, low education, dropouts from schools, in which, like, the population from the Dominican Republic is 10 million people, 700,000, about 700,000. And only 50% get to reach the first grade. 22% get to finish the 8-year cycle, and only like 10% of all the population get to finish secondary school. So apart from that, there is also a lot of underage drinking in the Dominican Republic and teen pregnancies. Like 1 out of every 10 girls living in the Dominican Republic gets pregnant. So yes, all of this is happening in the Dominican Republic, and most especially in this place called Arroyo Manzano. But what is Arroyo Manzano? Arroyo Manzano is a community very close to our school in which all of these rates are particularly high. This all due to the lack of extracurricular activities in school and the excess of drinking places.
Why we care? With this project, we realize how privileged we are and how with this great fortune comes great responsibility. So this opened our eyes to these forces that exist so close around us and awakened our sense of solidarity. By helping the less fortunate, we help our whole society. We really hope to close the social gap that is in our community.
Our project is Manzano Agua. Our vision is sustainable smiles. Our mission with this project is providing the youth of Arroyo Manzano with intercurricular education and empowering multipliers in the community to ensure sustainability.
Now I'm going to talk to you about our culture camps in Arroyo Manzano. So one of the first activities we did is that we did an imperfect workshop. A imperfect is a campaign that we created that promotes self-love and individuality. In this campaign, we did some activities to boost our self-esteem. Another accomplishment that we did is that we did Zumba Change for the Better. This was a project we did with Coach Thomas. He is a coach from Chicago, which has a program called Change for the Better. His program promotes a healthy living and healthy lifestyle and also physical activities. His program has participated with people such as Michelle Obama, and he came all the way from Chicago to participate in our project.
Another accomplishment was the Christmas ornaments, where we went to the community to spread the Christmas joy by creating Christmas ornaments to provide a creative outlet. Also, our New Year's goal. Our mission is to empower able communicators that efficiently accomplish their goals. At the beginning of the year, we went to the community to hear about their goals and talk about how they can reach them.
Our nutrition workshop. One of the problems of this community is malnutrition. Their diet should consist of cheap, highly processed foods from colmadas. Does anyone know what a colmada is?
No.
Well, the colmada bodega is a mini market slash very small convenience store that has everything from toilet paper to alcoholic drinks and gallons of water. So to help solve this problem, we arrange a guest lecture from a well-known nutritionist and health coach to help them build up like an affordable, well-balanced diet. Some of our future activities include a yoga class, social skills workshop, percussion class, and sexual education.
Some of our accomplishments in our structure group were that we want to see available spaces for future activities, and we arrange architects and engineers to create a budget and DET design space. We send letters to the mayor and companies asking for funds so we could build a place for the kids. Also, we contacted people from the community to set up a permanent location, but unfortunately, this place to the budget was one million pesos, so we couldn't do it and decided to use the money something else and something sustainable.
Struggles. Our most important struggle during this project was the issue we had with the community center we tried to build, to remodel. We tried to get a community center that looked like this, but in reality, it looked like this. And as you can see, all the windows are damaged, the roof is falling down, everything is dirty and damaged, etc. Another expectation was that we tried for our activities to look like this, with all the kids in a nice place, enjoying activity. But in reality, we couldn't do it. Our last expectation was, we tried to get a soccer field for the kids to play and have fun. But in reality, this is what they had. So as you can see, during every project, you struggle, but you need to move on. But right now, what we're working on for future plans is getting a permanent location for our events and activities with the kids.
So what have we learned from all this? So we're going to go through 2 points, which is our short-term goals and our long-term goals in this project. So for short-term goals is based on 3 points. One is that we want to create or find a permanent place so that we can be able to do all of our activities. Two is volunteers. We want to find as many volunteers as possible so that each activity may be more interactive and more fun to the children. Third is that is funding our resources. Why? Because in order to make a better and more fun activity, so we have much better materials and that we